Welcome to my talk on understanding of Bernoulli's equation, the most used fluid dynamics equation. Here, two important examples would be introduced. One is the modified outflow from a water tank, which is very similar to the original Bernoulli's experiment to establish the relation of the fluid pressure and the velocity. That is the famous Bernoulli's principle. But the modified experiment would be better as an example for Bernoulli's principle. The second example is the Venturi tube, which is a very useful measurement for pipe fluid, including the velocity and the flow rate. In these two examples, we will see how we can use the Bernoulli's equation to explain the fluid phenomena. Daniel Bernoulli was the first person who linked and initialized the relation between the fluid pressure and velocity for fluid dynamics. This is the most important relation for fluid dynamics, as we see today. Using an experiment in the drawing below, he stated a principle, the Bernoulli's principle. So in the experiment, it can be explained as this. Near the bottom of the tank, the flow velocity is very small, thus the corresponding pressure is high, which is indicated by the height of the water in the tank. While in the pipe, the flow speed is larger. As he observed from the experiment, the pressure in the horizontal pipe is smaller, indicated by the water height H in the vertical tube, which is lower than the water height in the tank. Based on his observation, he established the famous principle, now named as Bernoulli's principle. Pressure decreases when the velocity increases. He did some exploration on the phenomena using the energy conservation principle. It was Euler who actually derived the general Bernoulli's equation for inviscid flows in 1752, given as this. This is a very useful equation in fluid mechanics and fluid dynamics. In modern fluid dynamics, there are different forms of Bernoulli's equations, such as the conventional Bernoulli's equation for inviscid flows given in here, and the Bernoulli's equation for the potential flow given in this form. For both of the Bernoulli's equations, they have same requirements. The fluid is inviscid. For most conventional flows, air and water, their viscosity are very small. Hence, they can be regarded as inviscid flows in many practical applications. In compressible flows, it is true for the water. It is essentially incompressible. And for air, it is incompressible too if the air speed is not very high. For instance, less than 100 meters per second, or the Mach number is less than 0.3. The conservative body force. The fluid gravitational force is a conservative force. And for these two different Bernoulli's equations, they have also specific requirements. For the conventional Bernoulli's equation, the flow must be steady, and it is only varied on the flow streamline. For the potential flow, the important assumption is the flow is rotational, and this Bernoulli's equation is valid for the entire flow field. In practical applications, these two Bernoulli's equations are normally regarded as one due to the following facts. To find the fluid streamline, it's difficult in most applied cases in paper flows or channel flows. The whole flow can be regarded as a stream tube. In fact, such a pipe flow or channel flow is equivalent to a potential flow. Time-varying potential flow may be only seen in some specific case, such as in water wave. As far as I can see, the only applications for the unsteady Bernoulli's equation. Thus, for the steady potential flow, the expression of the Bernoulli's equation would have the same form as that of the conventional Bernoulli's equation, simply by dropping the time-varying term this term. Now we look at the first example. This example is very similar to the drawing Bernoulli himself drew. But here we use two pipes of different size, see here. Here we take an example. The water height in the tank, H1, is 4 meters, and the diameter of the pipe, the large pipe, D3, 0.12 meters, and the small pipe, 0.1 meter in diameter. And the orifice has a diameter of 0.08 meters. So to carry out the calculation, we assume all friction loss is small and ignored. And this can be acceptable if the flow speed is not very high. The flow in the pipes are uniform, and this is also acceptable if the measurement points are away from the sudden change for the pipe flow. The flow is steady, hence we assume the water height in the tank is a constant. So in this problem, we need to find out the velocities V3 here in the large pipe, V4 here in the small pipe, and V5 at the outlet. And the water height in the small vertical tubes, H3 here and H4 here. So before the calculation, we need to do some analysis based on the chosen coordinate here. So we can see at the point P1, the velocity V1 would be 0, and Z1 would be H, and P1 would be P0. The atmospheric pressure. And at P3, the velocity is unknown. We need to find out. The position Z3 can be regarded as 0 since it's very small and can be ignored. P3 is unknown. The corresponding H3 is unknown. The diameter of the pipe is 0.12 meters. And the section area S3 is given by 0.0113 meters square. Similarly, at the point 4, V4 and P4, H4 are all unknown, and Z4 is 0. The diameter is 0.1 meter, and the section area given by A4. At the point 5, V5 is unknown. Z5 is 0, and P5 is P0, the atmospheric pressure, because P5 is exposed to the atmosphere. So the diameter of the orifice is 0.08. The section area given by A5. Here, we apply the Bernoulli's equation on point 1. So for deciding the integral constant C0, given as this, at the point 1, V1 would be 0, so we can have the expression for C0 as this. And we apply the Bernoulli's equation on point 5 and use C0. So we have this from the Bernoulli's equation. And since Z5 is 0, so we have the expression as this. And we can put these expressions together. We have the equation given as this. So we can calculate the velocity V5 given as this. It is 8.859 meters per second. And based on the continuity equation, we have A3 times V3 equaling to A4 times V4 equaling to A5 times V5. Since we already obtained the section area S3, A4, and A5, and we use V5, we can calculate the velocities V3 and V4 given by this result. Now we can apply the Bernoulli's equation on point 3 given here, and we notice G3 is 0, so we can have the expression as this, P3 minus P0 equaling this and this expression. So the water height H3 in the vertical tube can be calculated given by this expression. So we can calculate H3 equaling to this expression. It is 3.21 meters, slightly less than the water tank, which is 4 meters. Similarly, we can apply the Bernoulli's equation on point 4, and the water height in the vertical tube, H4, is given as this, and we obtain the value of H4, 2.362 meters. This is significantly lower than the water height in the tank, H1 equaling 4 meters. Now in the summary, we can see if we compare point 3 and point 4, we can see the velocity at point 3 is smaller than the velocity at point 4, but the corresponding height H3 is larger than H4. This means the pressure at the point 3 is higher than the pressure at point 4. So this proves the Bernoulli's principle. Pressure decreases when the velocity increases. See, the velocity increases from V3 to V4. But the pressure decreases from H3 to H4.